I still can't believe that Japan has so many of these places for free. Good morning, people. It's 7:20 in the morning and we're about to leave yet another beautiful campsite. This place was actually closed for a couple weeks because there was a bear that was seen here, right here. So we were lucky that it was open, but still there are signs everywhere to beware of bears and not to leave food out here because that attracts many wild animals. This place is also a free campsite. We got toilets over there and we got a water station. Apparently the toilets are really, really dirty. I didn't go in. Everybody says it's better just to go in the bushes, and that's exactly what I did. It is really rare because usually toilets in Japan are super clean, even in free campsites. But anyway, today is actually our last day of touring in Hokkaido. It is a bittersweet moment because we have loved our time here, but it's time to keep going, guys. Time to go. We met a couple of guys yesterday from the camping cars. These people, they were super nice. We talked for a very long time yesterday with them, and they're traveling all over Japan. That's very, very cool. Okay.
ありがとうございます。お楽しんでください。またね
They're waving goodbye. Such a nice couple. They were from Osaka. Wow, it seems to be a sunny day. We need a sunny day after that rain from yesterday, the clouds.I just can't believe this is our last day of riding our motorbikes in Hokkaido. I'm sad and happy at the same time. I have loved riding in Hokkaido. The nature is beautiful, really beautiful here. But I'm also excited to go to new places in Honshu. So yeah, today is not really our last day in Hokkaido because we're gonna be spending a couple of days at the campsite. We're gonna be arriving later on today just to catch up with some work. We are gonna be driving for a little bit less than 200 kilometers today. It's not that much. We are gonna be going to the southern peninsula of Hokkaido.
I really had to clean this bike a little bit. It was way, way too dirty because of the rain yesterday. And while cleaning it, I actually found the bolts here that hold the exhaust were pretty, pretty loose. So Kaito is tightening it up for me right now.
Every once in a while, we check all of the screws off my bike. Whenever I clean the bike as well, I double check every screw. And every time we find at least one that is loosened. Yesterday when we were driving up to the campsite, I really thought that the water was murky because of the rainfall. But it turns out it's actually because it's mixed with hot spring water. Crazy, right? I think it's the first time I've seen something like that, like a river. Beautiful.
One of the things I love about traveling to these rural places is that you can find sometimes these little shops on the side of the road, and you find some local vegetables or seasonal fruits, and there's no one there to sell them to you. So it's just a trust system You basically leave the money there in a small box and you take whatever you want. That's pretty cool. Wow! Beautiful lake! There are so many lakes on the west side of Hokkaido, and the most interesting thing about them is that most of them are actually calderas. So they used to be volcanoes that erupted maybe thousands of years ago, and now they are very, very deep lakes. I think it's the case with this one as well. This is the Toya Lake. Such a beautiful day to ride next to this lake. What happened here? Ooh. Can we go? Oh, we need to stop. Looks like a landslide here. Look at all those bags with pet bottles and cans. Man, that's a lot. I mean, when you see it like that, you really think twice before buying a plastic bottle, you know, a plastic water bottle. We've been waiting here for a couple minutes already. And there has been a lot of trucks passing by, and I'm receiving all the dust. And I just cleaned my motorbike. I feel like it's already dirty. Ah, mo atsui hontou ni. Honshu wa dou naru kana? Okay, mo yakitori ni narimasu yo, koko. Hontou ni o yakiori. Big, big hotels just in front of the lake, and they all have hot springs. There are so many hot springs here in Hokkaido. I mean, well, there are volcanoes everywhere, so no matter where you go, there will always be a hot spring. Most of the time, whenever we have the choice between seaside route or the mountain route, we always choose the seaside. It was the case today, but somehow we couldn't even see the sea. We were the whole time in between the mountains. I keep on wondering where the sea is. Ah, there it is, the Pacific Ocean. These beaches along the coast of Hokkaido are usually very, very long beaches, but most of the time it is prohibited for tourists to go inside and swim in these areas. One of the things I enjoy the most about riding here, definitely not that. One of the things I've enjoyed the most about riding in Hokkaido is the fact that you can ride for kilometers and kilometers before finding any stoplights. I think it's gonna be something to get used to whenever we go back to Honshu, and we'll have to go across big towns. We'll have to stop almost at every corner. We are now going toward Hakodate, the south of Hokkaido. Oh, it's really hot today. Hakodate to the left. Bikers here are riding without any jacket. That's how hot it is. Hakodate, 102 kilometers. We've been on this road for over 30 minutes now, and the whole time it's been like this, straight. The wind is really crazy here. Whenever we have a truck passing by, it just pushes me to the side. My God. Woo! Yeah, fine. Wow. The first stop in over 30 minutes of being in this straight road. Woo. The temperature really does change a lot. Just a couple of nights ago, I was sleeping with my jacket on. And now, oh, let's see if I can breathe a little bit. And now it's like, it's really, really hot at night. Even when we let kind of the window open in the tent, we have some cool air coming in, so it's still okay. But I wonder, whoa! What's that? Kaito got something in his goggles. Look at that butterfly there. Oh my God, look at this little buddy. It was trapped there. Wait. Goggles, goggles, goggles. I managed to put in my goggles somehow. The amount of wildlife that we have killed while driving our motorbikes, it's unbelievable. The number of butterflies, flies, bugs in general that have crashed against us while driving is just uncountable. It's time for a little break. Need to stretch my legs. Oh. Oh. Feels great. Oh. We found an Italian restaurant about 6 minutes away from here, and it's already 12:21, so we're gonna be stopping there for lunch before heading to the campsite. It's so hot that it's the first time I open my jacket like this just to let the air in. Okay, Piatto.
And having a tomato sauce pasta with mozzarella and eggplants, and Kaito's having
cabbage and anchovy.
Hey, ご飯も久しぶりにレストランっていう感じのところで食べましたね。ガソリンが危ないんで目の前にあるガソリン入れます。ここら辺はガソリンが今までいたところに比べてかなり安いです。ここみんなすごいスピード出すんで反対側行くのがなかなかのレベルですよ。これはうわ行きましょう。意外とスムーズに行けるじゃない。オイル交換680円、安っ。安いぜレギュラー。細かいですねオリさん。 OK です。はい、ありがとうございました。OK、 空気圧も見て、ちょっとこのクワドロックっていうブランドのこのスマホホルダーを使ってるんですけれども、これが外れそうになってたんで緩んでたんで、やっぱりこれだけ走ると緩みますね。工具を借りて直しました。これちなみにおすすめですよ、クワドロック。すごいいいです。止まってると暑い。夏です。北海道も夏は暑いっていうか南が暑い。 さあ、パスタの次は皆さんわかりますよね。デザートです。最近ハマってるデザートがありまして、そのデザートを食べに行こうかなと思います。海入りてー、こんなに海が近いのにこの暑さの中入れないっていうのは辛いです。北海道最後のライディングの日になって、このもう雲一つないですよ。雲一つなく海がとても綺麗に見えます。真っ青です。そして向こうにはかすかにでかい山が見えます。わお。来ました、僕たちが最近ハマってるデザートが売ってる場所に。セイコーマートって言うんですよ。もう毎日来てます。
これですよ、このデザート、北海道チョコレートクッキーバー。これがむちゃくちゃうまいんです。毎日食べてます。うめえ。
さあ、今からキャンプ場に向かいます。あと1時間ぐらいで着くはず。ウォーウォーウォーウォー、あの山がかなり近く見えました。雪？ちょっと白いですね。すごい変わった形の山ですね。見たことない形。あの真ん中のところが噴火したんでしょうか。面白い形。バオバオバオピンピン、 This is the song for the broken hearted。 バオバオバオ。ここら辺は街灯もないから夜はかなり動物が出そう。右が湖です。あとちょっとで着きます。この湖の今回は湖畔で泊まります。最高でしょ。最高のロケーションですよ。あ、これですね、駐車場はこれか、右側か。来ました。おお、いい感じじゃない。オッケー、ヒグマの目撃情報がある。
We are all set up in this new campsite. We have our tent over here, and right in front of us, the most amazing view. We just found another free gym to exercise. Can you guys believe that? We're in this small town of Nanae, and they have this gym for the people who live here, for tourists, for everybody who wants to come to exercise. That is pretty, pretty amazing. This place have changing rooms and they also have free showers. They have a couple of sinks here and the free shower is over here. Something very basic, but it is amazing that it's for free. And they have hot water. Amazing. This is where they have the training. So it's getting ready. To exercise, they have a couple of machines over here and some cardio machines over here. I still can't believe that Japan has so many of these places for free. Good morning, people. I actually didn't want to finish this video before showing you around this beautiful campsite. We're going to be spending here a couple days before going down to Aomori. So let me show you around. We've got our tent set up here. We're actually drying some clothes right now. And we got it just in front of this beautiful lake. Look at that. There are actually a lot of wildlife around this campsite. We got a lot of bears coming to visit us every morning. They're actually quite noisy. And there are a lot of foxes on this road right over here, like so many of them. This campsite is actually free. There is a big parking space. There are two water stations with a cooking area, and there are very clean bathrooms as well. This is one of the water stations over here, and the building you see over there is actually the toilet. I'm gonna show you inside the bathrooms. We got the women's bathroom over here and the men's bathroom on this side. We've got a couple of Japanese style toilets. And there is one Western style toilet. They're all very clean. This is actually one of our three top campsites in Hokkaido. And it's actually the last campsite we're gonna be sleeping at in Hokkaido before going down to Aomori.
Oh.
Yes, a bittersweet moment.
If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and please subscribe down below.
See you in the next adventure.
Bye. Bye.